a Target 5 investigation for you tonight. Cincinnati Public Schools has taken a lot of heat, accused of mismanaging its money. The district has cut jobs, closed schools, and asked voters for tax hikes to try and stay afloat.
But there's one potential pot of gold CPS has refused to tap into, a multi-million dollar art collection you've probably never even heard about. Our Flack has the story. And Eric, you know, a lot of people wondering, where did all this art come from?
Well, Sandra, it was donated years ago by students, teachers, and alumni. But now the rare collection sits largely hidden away, and considering their current money problems, some say it's time for CPS to cash in. At Cincinnati's Museum Center.
There's a ton of stuff. There's the Children's Museum that's downstairs.
There's something for just about everybody.
We haven't actually been to that yet, but yeah, we've heard a lot about it.
Yet far less known is what could be the center's most valuable display, a collection of paintings that includes some of Cincinnati's most famous artists. Names like Duveneck, Potthast, and Farney. But it's the name of the collection's owner that might be the most surprising, the financially strapped Cincinnati Public School System.
The importance to the school system is truly its importance to the community.
The collection was started in 1895 by seniors at Hughes High School. They gathered donations from fellow students and started buying paintings from local artists to decorate the halls. The idea caught on at other schools, where teachers and alumni also started giving. Today, CPS owns 90 19th and 20th century works, appraised at around $6 million.
I didn't know that. Say that number again.
$6 million.
It's extraordinary. It's a lot of money.
Money that some city council members say should be used to help CPS dig out of a financial hole that's forced the school system to eliminate 120 jobs, close four schools, and once again ask for a tax increase to generate revenue. The third time CPS has done that in 8 years.
And I would say, you know, the public schools have a primary mission that in many respects they haven't done well. And so let's focus on doing your primary mission better and not get astray of collecting artwork.
But school board member Susan Cranley, who spoke to us on behalf of CPS, says the school system feels a responsibility to hold on to the art because, as it sees it, the art is a part of the city's history.
It isn't ours to sell. It's ours to take care of or make sure that it's appropriately cared for so that it will be there for generations forward.
The collection's impact on this generation remains in question. While some of the art is hanging in Museum Center, the majority of the paintings are on racks in a storage facility. Even more of the art will end up in storage later this summer when CPS puts the entire collection in the care of the Cincinnati Art Museum, which only plans to display 9 of the paintings in its gallery. It's just enough to keep the artwork in the public eye at a time when CPS's financial decisions are under the microscope.
Because it isn't as if we're mothballing it and not allowing anyone to see it. It is the exact opposite is happening. It is being used to educate the public, which is our job.
Cranley says even if the art collection were auctioned off, there is no guarantee the school system would really get the $6 million it was appraised for. Now, tonight at 11, hear from one family dealing with all these CPS cutbacks, a family who says that the school system needs to sell whatever the price.
Well, we should also mention that CPS needed something like $70 million, so they needed a lot more than the $6 million. But
the art collection could save individual things. Right. Those schools that got closed, it was $1 million apiece.
Have they ever, by the way, sold any of this artwork before?
About 10 years ago, sometime in the 90s, some of the pieces were sold off, and apparently it was met by an outcry, especially from the art community, who said you cannot do this. And so they really haven't brought up that topic since.